Okay, let me record the session and let me share the screen. Okay, right, fine, fine. Okay, so sometimes, okay, the build number is different from the Object Explorer to the query results. Okay, the table results, it will show different number. What is the problem? That means the last patch is not successful. In those cases, usually here it will show one number, here it will show another number. So that is the thing. So make sure both are showing same numbers. Okay, right. So let me do one thing before discussing. Let me download a 2014. Okay, now I am going to patch the SQL Server 2014, right? So sorry, I'm sorry, SQL Server 2017. 14.0 means 2017, right? So which service pack I have to download for this? I want to patch this SQL Server. Which service pack I have to download? I want to patch this SQL
Server. There is no service pack for 2017, right?
Very good. Okay. So there is no service pack for 2017. So I have to download, okay, cumulative update.
CPU.
So, okay. So CU, not CPU. Okay. So if you see here, okay, I can see 2017 software and latest CU is CU24, which was released in the May 2021. Means 2 months back it was released. Not 2 months back, 1 month back it was released. Okay. So let me click on this CU24 so that I will get the link for the CU24. You can download it. Yes. Yes. Any questions? Right. Okay. So no issues. So this is my link for CU24. You can download the CU24 from this link. Microsoft only, support microsoft.com. 1 minute. Parameshwar. Okay. I gave you the recording permissions, I guess. Let me check again. Parameshwar Reddy. Okay. Yes. You can record the session. Okay. Right. Okay. So cumulative update. Let me check the, yes, you can see here. If you go down, download the latest cumulative update package for 2017. Please mute it. If you don't have questions, please mute. Please mute. Okay. Right. So just click on this U24. Okay. You will get this link, Microsoft link. Then if you go down a little bit, there you can see small letters, download. Okay. The latest cumulative update package. Okay, for 2017, money, I don't see recording option for you. Okay, I don't know why I cannot see the recording option for you. So that's why I didn't give recording permissions for you. Just click on this link so that you can download the cumulative update. Okay, the cumulative update download will start. So you have to click here. So usually sometimes, guys, remember one thing. Usually the files sizes will be the service pack files or cumulative updates file sizes would be, okay, 500 MB to 1 GB. Okay, file sizes would be 500 MB to 1 GB. Okay, let me check whether I have already downloaded this cumulative update. Why? Because today my internet is not good. It is taking a lot of time to download. Let me check whether I have already downloaded the same cumulative update or older version of cumulative update. Yes, we have one cumulative update. Okay, this is fine. Okay, so see, like this, the name will be like this, SQL Server, the version name will be there. KB article means knowledge base article. Okay, KB means knowledge base article. And you can see this is the 2017 and it was downloaded on 22nd February. So it is not latest cumulative update, but it may be CU23, something like that. Okay, so what I'll do is same process, applying CU21, CU22, CU1 or 2 or CU24, anything, process is same, the file is going to be different. Okay, now I am downloading the CU24, right? Right, I have already CU22 or 23, I guess this is. What I'll do, simply I'll copy this file to my virtual machine, okay? Let me check any other files I have. SQL Server 2017, there are two files. Let me check what are those two files. One is KB0000000577. Okay. What is that file? One minute, guys. I'm not downloading. Why? Because downloading usually takes 3 hours because of my internet speed. So I'm canceling the download. I have already downloaded this file. So that's why I'm searching the file. Okay. 1 minute. Yes, this is the one. This was I was downloaded in the April, right? So this is the one. This is the latest one I have. Okay, let me copy this cumulative update to the virtual machine. Usually what you have to do in the organization, you will have shared paths. Simply you have to open the shared path. In the shared path, either manager or your team lead will download the service pack and they will keep it inside the shared path. Simply you will connect to the server. You will open the shared path like that. I told you right last time to open the shared path, something like this. A path will be there. SQL shared softwares, service packs, like this path will be there like this again, don't open this path in the organization. Okay. Right. Like this, a kind of shared path will be there. Just try to, okay. Open, just try to get this shared path details from your colleagues. They will give you the shared path details and all. Simply open, you have to open the shared path from the server from where you are going to patch, go to the server, open the shared path and copy the service pack. Don't try to directly patch your SQL server from the shared path. Copy the file from your shared path to your server, like how I am doing now. Right click, copy, right click, paste. That's it. Okay. Once you just copied the pack, then we can start patching the SQL server. Okay. Yes. Any questions?
Sir.
Yes.
Naveen, well, yeah, sir.
Of course.
Naveen, well, can you explain what is the hotfix one, sir?
Hotfix. I told you, right? Hotfixes. We have already discussed. Hotfixes means GDRs, QFPs. Those are also updates only. Hotfixes also updates only. That is a different kind of update. I told you, right? In case if something happened tomorrow, you don't wait for the next cumulative update, right? Already there is a cumulative update released on last month. Okay. If your server is hacked, can you please mute it? Mute in case if you don't have questions. Okay. In case in the last month, the patch is released, CU is released, but the server is affected tomorrow. The new virus came tomorrow. So last month pack doesn't contain the virus files, antivirus files for the tomorrow's issue, right? So, but you cannot wait for the next month cumulative update. So what Microsoft will do immediately, if any service attacks or any threats came or any virus came into the market, immediately Microsoft team will work. They will try to release a new update by the end of the day, or in 1-2 days they are going to release a hotfix. Hotfix means they are going to release an update immediately if they are attacked with any of the softwares, any of the virus files. Okay, so that is called hotfix. Okay. Usually we have two types of hotfixes. One is GDR and QFE, General Distribution Release, Quick Fix Engineering. If there are any bugs in the software, that can be achieved by QFEs. If any security threats are there for the software, that can be achieved by the GDR files. But again, QFEs, GDRs, those are also again cumulative updates only. Simply the name is GDR and QFE. So again, you have to download, like how I am downloading the software or how I am downloading the service pack or cumulative update file from the website. In the same way, you have to download those files and you have to patch the SQL server with the same updates. Patching is same. I told you, right? There is no different process in patching with SP, in patching with CU, in patching with the GDR, in patching with the QFE. Only files are different. Patching process is same. Patching is also same. Okay. Clear? Right, fine. So let me discuss other pending points as well. Then we'll start patching the SQL server. Okay. Okay, Guru, you don't have permissions. Guru and Guru Prasad, let me give you the recording permissions. Okay, Guru Prasad, you can record the session. I guess you are recording. Right. Right. What are the other pending points for patching? Reboot the server once. Yes, we just discussed it, right? Before patching, what you have to do? For smooth patching, you have to reboot the server once. Okay. And next thing is take the backup of all the databases, which is not possible, guys. Okay. In case if you have one or two databases, yes, this is okay. Okay. Why? Because after patching, sometimes server won't come online. SQL Server won't work. Imagine that is the very worst case. Okay. In case if it is not coming on, in case, okay, if it is very old server, if it is not coming online, then what you have to do is, as a precautionary step, try to take the backup of all the databases. After patching, if SQL Server is not working as expected, or it's not running, or it's not coming online, then what you can do is you can simply restore the databases with the existing backup files. So I don't, okay, encourage this thing. Why? Because taking backup itself will take 2 hours, 3 hours if there are big databases are there. So instead of that, what you can do is you can ask Windows team to take the VM snapshot backup. VM snapshot means they are going to take the whole machine backup, whole server, Windows server backup they are going to take, which may take hardly 10 to 20 minutes, depends upon the server size. If something happened to the SQL Server after patching, you can request VM team to restore the existing VM backup. Okay, so they are going to recover the whole Windows machine if something happened while patching. Okay, so that's why instead of going for individual databases backup, you can request Windows team to take the VM snapshot backup. VM snapshot means the whole machine backup. Okay, this is the machine, right? They will take the whole machine backup. If something happened to the SQL Server, they are going to restore, recover the machine. Okay, it won't take more than 20 minutes. Even the server is big, it will take hardly 20 to 30 minutes. Okay, the whole machine backup they will take. If things are not good, if server is not coming online after patching, they are going to restore the machine with the existing VM snapshot backup. That is good thing. You can request Windows team to take the backup, VM snapshot backup. Final check is check whether the machine is virtual machine or physical machine. This is also very important check. How to check whether my machine is a virtual machine or physical machine? Can anyone tell me? I want to check whether this machine is a virtual or physical machine. How to check whether the machine is a virtual machine or physical machine? Yes? Can anyone tell me how to check my machine is a virtual machine or physical machine? I guess we have already discussed it, right?
From system information.
Very good. Okay. From system information, you can check it. Okay. You can either type system information. Okay. You will get like this system information, or else there is a shortcut for this. If you remember or not, we have discussed in the earlier times, MS Info 32. Okay. You can use this shortcut also to get the system information. There, how to identify whether the machine is a physical or virtual? Okay.
System model.
Because this is showing virtual.
Yes, that's it. Yes. System model. Usually system model will tell you if it is a virtual box, VMware, hypervisor. Okay. You can see the names here. Virtual box, VMware, hypervisor. If it is a physical machine, it will tell you HP, Lenovo, okay, Asus, or Dell servers. Okay. Or else some different companies are there, right? Vendor names. You can see the vendor names directly if it is a physical machine. If you see virtual box, VMware, hypervisor like this, if you see this virtualization technology names, that means it is a virtual machine. Okay. So this is also very important, guys. Check in case if it is a physical box, not virtual box. Physical box, there is a limitation. Okay. Physical box means imagine the server is in the US. You are patching from India. The server physical machine is in the US. Simply from India, you are patching, you are controlling a machine from the US. From your location, you are controlling a machine from the another country or another location.
What is the challenge? If it is a physical machine, if someone restarted the physical machine, if machine is not coming online, you cannot connect to the machine to complete the patching, right? If it is a physical machine, if it is a virtual machine, if it is not coming online, Windows people can take the virtual machine console and they can restart it again. But if it is a physical machine, you just shut down the server. Or you just restarted the server, something happened, server is not coming online. Then how to fix that issue? It is a physical machine. You cannot take control until the machine comes online, right? Even Windows people also can't take control until the machine is online. Okay, so in case, imagine my machine is there in the US Dallas state, in Dallas data center, I have a machine. The machine is suddenly, it was you just restarted before patching as per the process you just restarted, but while restarting, okay, the machine is not coming online. So you cannot take control of the machine. So what you have to do in case if it is a physical machine from different data center, make sure one resource is available in the data center so that in case if something happened, the server is not coming online, as in the data center, in the Dallas data center, someone will be there to turn on the machine and to check why the machine is not online. Some Windows people will be there. They are going to help you out. Okay. So this is very important, guys. Before patching, check whether the machine is physical machine or virtual machine. If it is physical machine, try to patch it on weekdays. Don't go with the weekends. Okay. Why? Because weekdays, someone will be there in the office. Weekends, no one will be there. Again, you have to wait till Monday. Okay. So that's why usually make sure at least one resource is available in the office. So if it is a physical machine, try to patch your server on weekdays. If it is a virtual machine, patch your server on weekends. Clear? These are all the main precautions of the SQL Server. Once you are clear with these precautions, then patching is very simple. What you can do is how to know whether my SQL Server is patched or not. Now I'm going to initiate the patching. Before initiating, yeah, how to know whether my machine is patched or not, successfully patched or not?
You would be able to see SP.
Sorry?
You would be able to see SP.
Task manager, we have to see
outside. Task manager.
Okay. Build number will change.
Okay. Yes, Sunny, you are saying
just
something.
Here you would be able to, just here you would be able to see SP something, you know, whatever the patch you would do, I think.
Where we can see SP? Or something?
Just the build. I think next to RTM or before that, something. I can't.
Very good. Okay. So the build number will tell you, okay? The build number will tell you whether your machine is patched or not. If you run this one, you see here, select at version. Here only you can see the answer. Microsoft SQL Server 2017 RTM 14.0.1000.169. Once you patched the SQL Server, the number is going to be changed. And here from RTM, you can see with which service pack you have or with which cumulative update you have installed, you can see the cumulative update in the brackets. Okay, now this is RTM. Once you patch this RTM with CU1, CU2, CU3 or CU20, after patching from RTM, it will change it to the desired cumulative update and the number will be changed to the desired cumulative update. Okay, right now, straight away, before patching, guys, what you can do is send an email to the whole DBA team. Why? Because imagine two people are supporting in the shift. You are doing work from the Bangalore. Another one is doing from Hyderabad. Okay. You are patching the server. The other guy, other DBA don't know that you are patching the server. While patching, the services will be down. Other DBA will think, okay, services are down. So he'll try to restart the service, which will throw the error, which may corrupt the instance. So make sure before patching, make sure you are going to send an email to the application owner, DBA team. Okay, so that they will come to know that you are patching the server. So in case if any alerts comes, if any errors comes, they won't do anything until the patching window is closed. Once the patching window is closed, still they are getting alerts, then they will start looking it. Okay, so what you have to do before patching, after patching, send an email. So I am patching so and so server. In case if you are getting any alerts, please ignore those alerts, so that no one can touch those server till the patching window is over. Okay, this is the best practice, right? This is my service accumulate update file. I just copied from my downloads to this machine. Right click, run as administrator. Patching is very simple, guys. Nothing will be there, like not installation. no options will be there to explain next patch it, but these things we have to know. Okay.
So if you have so for example SP or any other, generally when we install server or different version, so we get different windows, but with patching, even if it's a different version, but the process would be same, right?
Yes, same process. Patching 2005 is same, 2008 is same, 2012 is same, 2017 is same. Don't ask how to patch 2005 server. Same process, only the file is going to be differentiated.
Extract. Yeah. Okay. Yes. Thank you.
That's it. Okay. So there is, the file will be different. Remaining all things are same. Process is same. Protocol is same. Everything is same.
And how long generally it takes to patch a server?
Yes, very good question. Okay. So how long it takes to complete the patching? Okay. Depends upon the server size. It will usually take from 30 minutes to 1 hour. 30 minutes to 1 hour. If it is very big server, it will take 1 hour or 1.5 hour, hardly 1.5 hour. If it is a normal medium server, it will take 30 minutes. If it is small server, it will take 20 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Right. Okay. So here also you can see some checks. Okay. In that restart check is there in case if you don't restart the server before patching, you won't see the next button. The patch will be failed. So the solution is restart the server before patching. Click on I accept the license terms. Next. Right. Here, I'll tell you one thing. What if I have multiple instances? Okay. What if I have multiple instances of same version of different version? Let me straightly jump into the topic. In case if I have two 2017 instances, both are 2017 instances. Okay. If they are not, if both instances are not patched with the respect to cumulative update, you can see both instances here. In case you want to patch both instances, you can check like this. Okay. If you don't want to patch both instances, you can skip like this. If you want to patch one instance and you want to skip one instance, whatever instance you want to patch, select it. You don't want to patch and deselect it, simply like that, like this. Okay. In case if you have two instances of same version, I have two 2017 instances. If you want to patch both instances, select both the instances. If you don't want to patch both instances, unselect both the instances. If you patch one instance and don't want to patch another instance, select which instance you want to patch, unselect the other instance you don't want to patch.
So what if we have two instances with a different version?
Very good.
That same is process.
That is not eligible.
Okay.
Okay. If you see here, the option is grayed out, right? You cannot select or unselect, right? If you have another version, okay, simply you can see the version server name here, but you are not able to select or unselect option. Why? Because that instance is not eligible for this patch. Got it?
No.
See.
So, for example, in case
you have 2016, 2017, you are patching 2017. Okay. But you can see 2016 and 2017 in this list. But you cannot select or unselect the option. 2016 option.
Okay. It's grayed out.
Yeah. It's completely, it will be grayed out.
But so we cannot do anything with the 2016,
even if
it's on the same. Okay.
We cannot do anything. Yeah.
So would it be same for, would it be same every time, if we have a two different versions, so one would be grayed out and one would be.
Yes.
Enabled.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Right. And that's it. Okay. Like this, if you want to patch, you can patch the eligible instances. If you want to skip it, you can simply unselect the another instance, which you don't want to patch. Okay. From this window. Next. Again, it is going to check files, any other background files are running, any files are running in the background. If files are running in the background also, won't create any issue. Why? Because we already took the proper downtime. Okay. So nothing, not an issue. In case if you see any files are running in the background, you can simply go next. Okay, so that's it. Patching, like files are completed. These are the files currently running in the background, but it won't create any impact. Simply go next. So this is the final screen. Action is equal to patch command. It is going to create a command. Click on update. That's it. Okay, I told you, right? Depends upon the server size. As it is very small server, it won't take more than 15 to 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, it is going to be completed. Once the patching is completed successfully, I'll tell you how to see whether the patching is successfully completed or not. And I'll show you the build number. Okay, now it is currently showing 1000, right? After patching, it will be changed. Okay, I'll show you that one. Okay, so what you can do is just wait till patching is going to be completed. Okay, and in case if you have any questions, you can ask me. If you are patching two instances, okay, if you select both the instances, so it will show you one of two. If automatically it is patching first instance, once the patching of first instance is completed, it will show you two of two. Okay, two of two, one of two will be there. So you can easily identify as it is patching first instance and it is patching second instance like that. When if you have two instances, if you are patching both the instances, here it will show you MS SQL Server one of two. Two of two, like that, it will show you.
Usually in organization, how many server you will work, sir?
So it depends upon the company to company, sir. Some companies will have 10 servers, some companies will have 20 servers, some companies will have 100, some companies will have 1000, some companies will have 10,000 servers. It depends upon the number of applications they are supporting. It depends upon the number of clients they are supporting. It depends upon the number of projects they are supporting. Okay, there is no proper figure, fixed figure. In case if someone asked in the interview, okay, how many we can, how many servers you are supporting, you can tell any number from at least 1000 to 2000. Why? Because they want to know whether you worked on a large environment or not. So better go with the, I worked on 1000 servers. I'm supporting 1000 servers or 1500 servers like that. Okay.
How many you are supporting, Shan?
I'm supporting 8,000 servers.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm supporting 8,000 servers.
And how many people are in your team?
Usually my team, 15 members are there.
Okay. And yeah. What is your position?
I'll tell you later.
Okay.
Yeah. Any other questions, guys?
Sir, present, we are updating one instance, right?
Yes, yes.
If there is two instances are there. It will take more time or same time?
More time. How come same time it will take? Okay. It will take more time. Half an hour, 1 hour it will take.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
For suppose if there is, you said like 50 instances we can support, right?
15, sorry?
We can support 50 instances, right?
Yes, yes. In a machine, you will have 50 instances. You can have 50 instances.
But if we have to update all this, it will take some more time, right?
Yes, more time only. 50 into half an hour. How many time? How much time? 25 hours. Okay. 25 hours it will take. But no machine will have 50 instances, okay? Hardly 1 or 2 instances. Very hardly you can see 3 instances in a machine. Okay. 80% of the Windows machines will have only 1 instance. Okay. Remaining 10 to 15% machines will have 2 instances. 5 to 10% machines will have 3 to 4 instances.
Okay, okay.
No one will dare that. Why? Because if the machine is down, 50 instances will be down. How, imagine the big loss for them. 50 instances are down means not a small thing, right? So that's why, yes, you can save the money, lot of money by keeping all the instances in a single machine. But if something happened to the machine, Okay, if they cannot recover it, they can lose the whole data. Risk is very high if you are maintaining multiple instances in the same machine. So that's why they are going to maintain one or two instances hardly in a machine.
Yes, yes. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yes, okay, if you see here, make sure all the components are successfully patched. Okay, in that the main component is database engine. If it is failed, your patching has been failed. Even though if all components are successful, if the database engine is failed, okay, the build number won't be updated. Here the build number won't be updated. That if the database engine is patched successfully, then only the build number will be updated, then only the patching is successful completely. If all other components are successfully patched, but this is failed, that means your patch is unsuccessful. Okay. So in case you want to see the patching errors, whether patching is successful or failure, okay, you can see in the summary file. I told you, right? For installations, for patchings, for upgradations, for uninstallations, summary file will be generated. You can easily check the summary file from this link, or else go to C program files, Microsoft SQL Server 140 setup bootstrap folder, log folder. Okay, there also you can see summary file. From there also you can access the summary file and you can check it. Okay, right. Let me close this window as it is successful. Now let me refresh this one. Okay, if you see here 14.0, remember guys, major version, minor version don't change. Only third and fourth numbers will be changed. It's not compulsory that fourth number is changed. Okay, but the third number will be changed. Definitely the third number will be changed. Okay, then only the server will be patched. Sometimes the fourth number may be changed, may not be changed. Okay, let me refresh it now. See here, it went to 3381. Okay, let me run this query. Okay, if you see here, okay, I patched my SQL Server with RTM CU23. Okay, earlier you see only RTM, now you see CU23. I just patched my SQL Server with CU23. Now you see all the database states and all, whatever states earlier, same state should be there. Whatever states earlier of the services, same states should be there for the services as well. Okay, so this is how you can easily identify the patching is successful or not. Okay, so the number is going to be changed, the bill number is going to be changed. See here, in this case, earlier it is 169, right? It was changed to 3. Earlier it is 1000, right? It was changed to 3381. If you see here, if you run the select edit version, there also you can see 14.0.3381.3. Now that means your patching is successful. That's it, guys. Any questions, any doubts, let me know. Otherwise, the meeting is going to close in a minute. We'll meet in the next class tomorrow, 7:30 sharp. Okay.
Was interesting today.
Sorry?
Session was interesting. You know, last week it was boring because of three, but today it was good.
That would be nice. Yeah.
It was like whatever theory
yeah,
like,
oh, theory part
was
is
happening.
Yes.
Today was good. It was interesting, you know.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thank you for that. Okay, so that's it, guys. Okay, try to patch the SQL Server. Download any service pack or cumulative update. Try to patch it, guys. Okay, tomorrow I'll ask whether you have patched or not. Okay, thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Bless.
Yeah, bye.